that if we remove fees, shall we ensure that there will be quality education in UPE and USE? And the answer is yes.
The decision by the Ministry of Education to start carrying out a countrywide study on whether Ugandan parents are willing and able to pay fees in UPE and USE schools was decided early this week during the cabinet sitting at State House Entebbe. ICT Minister Chris Baliomunsi says the outcome of this study will inform government on whether to allow parents having children in UPE and USE schools to pay school fees or not.
And part of the findings of the study should be, if you are to discontinue or to prohibit payment of fees, how much more money should government invest in primary education and secondary education?
On several occasions, President Museveni has come out and warned teachers in UPE and USE schools against charging parents school fees, maintaining that it is illegal. Some schools have continued to defy the president's directive by charging fees, saying it is the only way they can effectively run their schools.
It is not the payment of fees which brings equality. It's not. We can have a debate on another day, but the education can still be free and you maintain quality education and you attain quality education.
On the part of the parents, some urge that their children under UPE are not getting good education because their schools and teachers are not well facilitated.
Look how far we've come from 1991, triumphing over.
Meanwhile, the government has expressed concern over the continued misuse of the internet, condemning those who went ahead to announce the false news of the death of the Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya. Government is now considering strengthening the Computer Misuse Act to bring the culprits to book.
There are those who communicate offensively, like declaring somebody dead, some cases which we take up as government. And this is true. Some of these messages which have been circulating, we are now hunting down the originators, in the sense that we are using technology to establish the people who originated these messages.
The minister also hinted on the increasing cost of essential commodities in the country, maintaining that the high price of goods is driven by external factors.
That this is a temporary situation. It's a temporary phenomenon which is global. So as Bank of Uganda deals with the stabilization of prices through the monetary policies, I want again to say, let's not panic, let's not lose hope, because in the coming months, this situation should be able to calm down.
Story by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.